A very warm welcome to all the students of Department of Education. I am Dr. Nalini Mishra, Assistant Professor from Department of Education. Today I'll be dealing with the topic program learning or program instruction, which is an important part in the syllabus of BA education, MA education and BEd as well. So let us start with this topic, with the meaning of program learning and characteristics of program learning. Program learning is a new innovation in the field of education, which deals with presenting the content matter to the students in a very individualized manner so that they are able to learn more. In program instruction, because it is an individualized technique, there is a process of self-pacing also which is implied to it. And the students are learning because in their own way and in the, at their own pace, in their own space as well. So they are able to learn more. The teaching learning process becomes more effective through this technique. Let us start with the definition of program learning. According to Smith and Murray in 1962, he has said, program instruction is the process of arranging the material to be learned into a series of sequential steps called frames, which moves the student from a familiar background into a complex and a new set of concepts, principles and understanding. With this definition, we see that the whole content matter is broken into small steps. That is called frames in the terminology of program learning. When the content matter is presented to a student in a series of steps and that too in small frames, the students are able to understand it more. And when they cross this frame one by one, they are able to gain mastery over the whole learning material produced before them. There are a few characteristics of program learning. The first one is, it is a method or technique of giving or receiving individualized instruction from a variety of sources such as program textbook, teaching actions and computers with or without the help of a teacher. It is an individualized technique and it is presented to a student, and a student learns at his own pace and in his own space. But a student cannot do without a teacher. If a teacher is not in front of him, teaching him, definitely the content presented to the student is made by the teacher. So the importance of teacher, the role of the teacher cannot be escaped. He is very important in designing this whole content matter too. So program learning, it is a technique which gives a good instructional way of learning to a student. The second one is, in this technique, the instructional material is logically sequenced and broken into suitable small steps or segments of the subject. Logically, it is broken up into small steps, that is from easy to difficult, which is a way of learning. When the content is presented to a student in this form, from the way he is understanding it more, when it is linked with his previous knowledge and from easy to difficult manner, of course, this content matter will be very effective and will help him in his learning. The third one is, for sequencing a particular unit of the instructional material, the programmer has to pay consideration to the initial level of the or the entry behavior of the learners, and it ends with the terminal behavior which the student is required to achieve. So the entry behavior and the terminal behavior, both are taken care of when this type of instructional material is presented before a student. The fourth one is, in actual operation, a frame is small, but it is very meaningful. And the learner is required to read or listen and then respond actively, which is also very important, because when he's reading and listening and he has to respond also, so he will become more active because he has to give responses which will be recorded also in the program instructions. So this is very helpful. This characteristics makes this program learning really useful in regular classrooms or wherever the learner is learning. The fifth one is, this learning system has an adequate provision for immediate feedback that is based on the theory of reinforcement. So this has a psychological perspective also. theory of reinforcement, which says when a good response or a correct response of a student is reinforced, the student will psychologically he'll feel like learning more because he's getting motivation through this reinforcement. So in program learning, when every response is being reinforced and he's feeling that before going to the next frame he should gain mastery over this and his scores will be recorded, so he'll be learning properly. The sixth one is, it is the interaction between the learner and the learning material or program that is emphasized in the program learning. Because he is learning and he is responding, this is the way he is interacting with the computer or the program instruction to learn the content, to learn the material that is given to him. Because it is through interaction, this interaction is made more effective by taking prompt responses from him. So program instruction material becomes very meaningful for a learner. The seventh is, it provides self-pacing. The learner, I've already said, the learner is learning at his own pace. When in a regular classroom, a teacher is going at his or her own pace, and a learner has to learn according to his or her teacher. But when he's learning through this program instruction material, he's learning at his own pace. Nobody is there to say that you should learn at this pace or this will be a proper way of learning. If he's not feeling like learning at a particular moment of time, he may switch over to some other time and he'll be feeling better to learn. So these kind of provisions are there in case of program instruction materials. So definitely this technique is new in the field of education, which is very innovative for a learner. The next one is, it has the provision for continuous evaluation that may help in improving the student's performance and also the quality of the instruction material that is presented. So because continuous evaluation is there, in which has been the focus of all the recent policies of government, that continuous evaluation makes a learner more learn more effectively. The provision that is very much there kept in this program instruction material, and this continuous evaluation helps the learner in getting feedback and learning more next time, or gives chance to him in learning the material better, also giving a chance to the teacher who has designed the instructional material to make it better. If he is getting the feedback from the students and he is evaluating the students' responses, he may reframe and he may redesign his instructional material, which may suit the learner better. With this, I'll stop my this lecture at this point of time, and in my next lecture, I'll be telling more about this program instructional material and dealing with the principles of instructional materials. Thank you all.